the tomato can. And whatever you have to say, say it in the sardines can.
I don't have to say it in any can. Ever since somebody mentioned the word movies around here, you've all gone crazy, acting like a bunch of nitwits, neglecting your land. You don't know anything about acting. What you know is farming, the richest, most rewarding heritage a man can have. Your fortune doesn't lie in a piece of celluloid. It lies in the land, in what you can grow and cultivate and harvest. Now, please take my advice and forget this nonsense and go back to your farm.
Let's plant that.
I'm so proud of you. That's the first thing Mr. Haley printed today.
Lisa, how can you fall for a maniac like...
Underplay it, Mr. Douglas. If you want to get into movies.
How can any of you possibly believe that Jimmy Stewart is going to come here?
Everybody, listen. Charlie just called from Bixley. Jimmy Stewart is on board the Cannonball. He'll be pulling into Hooterville at 2 o'clock. Anybody see him?
Nope.
Well, mister, if you mind stepping aside, we want to see Jimmy Stewart.
I'm Jim Stewart. Well, what happened to you?
I beg your pardon?
You don't look like Jimmy Stewart.
You don't sound like him either.
Well,
you lost a lot of weight and you got shorter.
You better start taking care of yourself or they'll be giving you those short, skinny parts.
Oh, no. I'm not Jimmy Stewart, the actor.
Then who are you?
I'm Jim Stewart, James D. Stewart. Look, is Mr. Douglas here?
What do you want with him?
Well, I'm here to make a documentary film about his farm for the Department of Agriculture.
You ain't going to make a Hollywood movie?
No.
Doggone. Why did you pick Mr. Douglas' farm?
This film is going to be about the pitfalls of farming.
Then you picked the right place, Mr. Stewart. There ain't a better pitfall in the whole county.
If this farm is a horrible example, it's the fault of the Department of Agriculture. I followed the instructions to the letter. I followed them carefully. All...
Mr. Douglas, let's get that point straightened out.
Yes, let's get that point straightened out.
Is this corn your worst crop?
Yes, if you don't look at the soybeans and the wheat. Better don't hit me in front of the government.
I wasn't going to hit you. Look, Mr. Stewart... I planted this corn according to the bulletins exactly. I planted the seed the bulletin recommended. I irrigated according to the bulletin.
Mr. Douglas, what was growing here before you planted corn?
I don't know. What difference does that make?
It makes a great deal of difference. Didn't you read the part about the importance of crop rotation?
He didn't read that book.
How about your soybeans?
Soybeans? Now, there, I planted them exactly as the bulletin directed. I limed the soil.
Mr. Douglas, how soon after the liming did you plant?
The very next day.
Mr. Douglas, if I remember, the bulletin clearly states if lime is needed, it should be worked into the soil at least 4 months before you plant.
Oh? Well, I probably missed that part.
I think you've been blaming us for your own negligence. You obviously don't read our bulletins carefully.
Look, I may have missed it. You probably didn't mail them.
Then you're blaming the charterheads.
It's quite possible I was very eager to get things into the ground. I may have rushed a little bit.
That's why we'd like to make the film, to help other people avoid your stupid mistakes.